In just a few minutes, small business owners can now sign up for Blackfoot Communication Services. Whether it's dependable voice options or internet services, sign up simply by visiting blackfootsmallbusiness.com. Click on the services you wish, select an installation time and date, and you're done. Small business services at the touch of your fingers. Connect to more with Blackfoot Communications and blackfootsmallbusiness.com.
All right, everyone, welcome to the weekly press conference from Montana State. We have team captains with us, Pat O'Connell, Mitch Roberts, Robby Hauck, and Coach Hauck. Coach, we'll start with your final thoughts after a dominant win for the Griz heading into the rivalry weekend.
Sure, it was great to get a dominating win over Eastern. Thought we played well in all three phases. There's some things we need to do better. We gave up too many yards. We weren't very good on third down on offense, and I didn't think we punted it well. So we'll keep working on everything, trying to be better. But that win puts us in the playoffs, I think. So now we can just get on and get ready for the next one. So I guess it's time to talk about that. In terms of the rivalry game, you know, I know they're well coached. Coach Vegan does a great job, man. He's a good coach. He's a good man. I have a lot of respect for him and how he does it. He'll have them ready to go. I'm excited for this game. I love playing down there. I just always have. I've just always really enjoyed it. I think I saw my first college football game there and just kind of always have enjoyed the games down there. So we've played well lately. We're going to need to play well again in order to have a chance to win this game. I assume we'll be an underdog in the game, but we've beaten this opponent 73 times in the history of this rivalry, and outside of Nebraska's 91 over Kansas, I don't know if there's a Division I team with more wins over one opponent, so we kind of have a feeling like we ought to win this game too. Preparation's interesting in our conference. You know, it's hard to get a gauge on people. I'm sure it's the same for them. We've seen them against, we've seen them against Cal Poly, Eastern, Idaho State. We haven't seen them against Sac State or Idaho. They haven't seen us against Northern Arizona or Northern Colorado, and then there's obviously some others too. But we're well into our prep. We've been studying the film for a couple of days now. We'll probably dig into the Oregon State game a little bit because they seem to have success against them. And it's time to get ready for this game, and it'll be a big game on Saturday.
Questions?
Coach, with game day coming down there, are you, you know, more excited about the opportunity for the state and the rivalry to be showcased, or is there any kind of feeling of being upset that they kind of snubbed Missoula last year? Which way are you leaning?
It doesn't really have anything to do with us. And it's eyes on our program, which is, it's good when the people are watching the Griz.
And which, what do you want people to take away and learn about your program, you know, with this opportunity when it's all said and done?
Let's talk about the game. I don't care about that stuff. I tried to indicate that. That's for you all. We got a game to play.
Do you want to start with them offensively or defensively? What do you want to do first?
I'd like to talk about us.
Okay. what do you want to – well –
You can think about it and give it to somebody else. Okay. Stumbling around.
Just start with Mitch, I guess. All three of you guys, players here, all from Montana, coach as well. Just Mitch, you know, being a hometown Missoula guy, just what has this game kind of meant for you? You got a chance to grow up and watch it and get a chance to play in it now as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's always been a huge game growing up watching it, and the opportunity to playing it the last few years and then this year, you know, it's always very special and means a lot to, you know, every Montana guy, and the out-of-state guys learn very quickly how much it means to them as well, and how big of a game it is. So, it's a joy to play in, and I'm looking forward to it.
To follow up on that, Mitch, just obviously last year you guys got the win over them to, you know, kind of snap their winning streak. Just how big was that just to experience that for this team, and how does that build confidence going into this matchup?
Well, yeah, I mean, anytime you get a win over an opponent, it's a big deal. It's hard to win in the Big Sky Conference. So, you know, any win is a big deal, and we try to do that every week, and hopefully we can get one this week.
Pat, you guys have been so good against the run this year. What have been the key factors that got into that?
Yeah, there's a lot of factors that go into that. Obviously, it starts up front. All the big guys taking up blocks. And then a lot of stuff that we do isn't quite like the stuff that other people do. So it takes a lot of preparation to play our defense, and I think that's a huge part.
Coach, it seems like... They can stop me. I'm all the way up. All the way up.
What you want, shorty, what you need. My niggas run game, we ain't never leaving. Counting up this money, we ain't never sleeping. You got V12s, I got 12 V's. Got bottles, got weed, got molly. I'm all the way up. Shorty, what you want, I got what you need. Shorty, what you want, I got what you need.
Seems like in the run game, Montana State's doing different stuff than they have done the last couple years, a lot more outside zone. What do you think of the matchup just in terms of your run defense against that run scheme?
Well, they're rushing for a lot of yards and putting up a lot of points. Expect the quarterback to run it a lot. The quarterbacks are their leading rushers. So, you know, there's some option component to it. You know, it's similar to what they have done in the past. I mean, they ran all this stuff last year against us.
You mentioned that they have two quarterbacks, but it doesn't seem like it changes much, no matter if Tommy Mellott or Sean Chambers is in the game. Do you see that?
Yeah, it's real similar. They aren't changing their offense. They're similar guys. You know, recent weeks, 10 hasn't played, so I don't know about that. But, yeah, it doesn't change.
Mitch, so often in this game, there's so much emotion, and a lot of the run games are stifled because there's such physical play. So a lot of times it comes down to the outside. What do you think of just your matchups on the outside, and what sort of your collective mentality as receivers going into this game?
Yeah, I mean, they got some good players, and you know, we try to go into the game making plays for our team on the outside as well, any given week. So I think that, I mean, it doesn't change. You know, got to go out there and make plays for my team, and you know, hopefully get a win, yeah.
Robby, similar question for you. What do you think has been some of the key factors to how well you guys have played defensively this year, particularly stopping the run?
Probably just our preparation and our work ethic. You know, it all starts even before the season and just the standard that we're held to by our coaches and then also the guys on our team. So, I mean, that probably is a good explanation of how we play on defense.
Robby, how... From a player perspective, how much fun is it being a part of this rivalry and knowing that it's, you know, the last one? Like, what's kind of the emotions of that?
I mean, it's awesome. You know, you set aside the teams. It's a pretty cool thing to be able to play in, to have the experience of an actual rivalry game. Both sides, I would assume everybody agrees with that. You know, it's a lot of fun. So, you know, the emotions get high and everybody wants to win. It makes a great game and a great rivalry.
Pat, what would you say is kind of the best thing about being able to be a part of a rivalry like this?
Yeah, I've been on both sides of the spectrum as far as winning and losing in the rivalry, so definitely the best part is winning, obviously. The preparation is a grind and it's awesome. But yeah, the best part is going out and beating them.
Coach, obviously, Mellott played against you guys last year, but limited at that point. What have you seen as far as his maybe growth since you faced him last?
Yeah, I don't remember how many snaps he played last year against us. Probably 25. He's a good player. Done a good job. Obviously, he's leading him in rushing. He's done a good job.
Defensively, they've obviously lost a few big names from last year. Have given up some yards the last few weeks. What do you see from them defensively?
They're very multiple on third down. Obviously, they're not telling us how they're going to play us, so we've had to begin preparation for a lot of different things. You know, I think they play hard. I think they're a tough team. I think that stems from their head coach and goes on through the team.
And then Robby, obviously their run game is kind of a highlight of their team this year, but you know, in the passing game, what do you see from them there, and what's the focus going to be like in the secondary, you know, during practice this week?
I mean, like you said, they run the ball well. They throw the ball well. They like to take shots downfield, so they're going to try to make some plays, and we have to make some as well.
Pat, it's probably been just frustrating not being able to take the field the last few weeks, but you've seen guys like Levi kind of step up and help some other guys on the defense kind of break out a little bit. Just what have you thought about, you know, even this last week you guys were without quite a few players, just seeing some of these other guys step up in two wins for you guys?
Yeah, I think it shows the attitude and the discipline of our team, and it stems from Coach Hauck all the way down to the players. Guys are always ready to come in, and guys are prepared, and they play to the standard, and to see that is awesome. Like you said, Levi and all the other guys that filled in did a great job, and they know what they're doing, and it's fun to watch your buddies and your friends go out and make plays. I'm happy for all of them.
And Coach, like you mentioned off the top, you enjoy getting a chance to play down there and, you know, play against this team. So what's it like kind of going on the road in an environment like that? And do you have any memories that kind of stand out in this rivalry going down there and playing in Bozeman?
Yeah, I got all kinds of memories, but it's always, you know, the game – it's a cool game because it's about the game between the two schools, and everyone's on either side of it's pretty passionate about it. Like I said, I've always enjoyed playing there.
Pat, on the road, you played a lot of, you know, ranked teams already this year. How do you think that might, you know, can help you guys out for the Saturday?
I don't know if it really changes much for us, honestly. I think we try and keep things the same no matter where we're at, which is always good. As far as preparation and leading up to the game, you want to keep things consistent, and I think we do that really well. So I don't think I mean, it definitely helps playing ranked teams on the road and stuff, but it won't play too much of a factor into it.
Coach, I always say, like, that you can throw records and all that out the window for rivalry games, and that they're just kind of more volatile. Do you think there's like a truth to that, and something about rivalry matchups that makes, I don't know, outcomes more random or things like that?
Yeah, I don't know. It didn't really apply in this game because we're both pretty highly ranked, but I don't know. In the history of college football, I'd say that's probably true.
And Pat, what's the key to kind of tempering your emotions and, you know, playing within yourself in a game where, you know, you're going to be hearing it from the sidelines and, you know, the whole week?
Yeah. You got to disregard all the outside stuff from all the people that don't really know what they're talking about. You gotta prepare like no one ever is prepared for a game like this. And then in the game, you just gotta stay even. You can't get too high on the good plays, and you can't get too low on the bad plays, and you can't make the game like a roller coaster. You just gotta stay even keeled the whole game, and that's the biggest part.
Robby, you've had an interesting perspective with this rivalry, just kind of growing up watching it as your dad the head coach, and, you know, just kind of being involved in that way. So, you know, prior to getting the first win for you in this rivalry, playing in it, you know, what were some memories that maybe stood out to you as you got a chance to watch it from a different perspective than most in this game?
I don't know. I mean, I kind of like to think that I had a little bit of a different perspective in my family compared to any given fan watching from the outside. So I don't know. It's a fun game to win, and that's what we're looking to do this weekend.
Mitch, yeah, most of those fans don't have their mortgage on the line.
Yeah, that too.
Haven't played in too loud of places on the road this year. What's the preparation going to be like, and what's that like playing in front of a loud crowd, especially when you're on offense?
Yeah, I mean, I'm assuming it's going to be a pretty loud game. The atmosphere is always pretty up and loud. So, I mean, we'll adjust and, you know, play accordingly and try to execute our offenses to the best of our abilities, no matter the atmosphere. So, yeah.
I mean, nobody wants to play in an empty, quiet place.
Yeah. Makes it fun.
Yeah. Go to Sac State and talk to the other coaches on the sideline. You know, it's good. We want.
For all three of you players, you guys have all either grown up or spent a lot of time in Montana. Is there anything you tell guys from out of state? Kind of, you know, is there a way to convey the rivalry without playing in it to, you know, guys on the team who aren't from here?
I think at first it's hard to really show them or tell them what it's all about until they get into it. But there's a lot of stuff you can tell them. Just, I don't want to say those things on camera, though. So, yeah, just to be ready.
Talk's talk.
Yeah.
I would say that they learn pretty quickly. Us Montana boys kind of convey pretty strongly about how we feel about them, and they understand pretty quickly of how big this rivalry is, and yeah.
I mean, you guys pretty much said it all, but I think as soon as you step foot into this program, you realize pretty quick how big this game is. So it kind of just speaks for itself.
It seems like we talk about it every week, Bobby, but how do you earn an advantage on special teams in a game like this?
You know, sometimes you get to this time of the year and you worry about the weather and all that stuff. That seemed to be okay the last couple of weeks. You know, field conditions down there are better now that they've got turf. I mean, it's not going to be frozen or greased like a couple of games in memory that stick out in my mind. So, you know, it's really about handling the ball and punting it, kicking it. You know, and I think Pat touched on this a little bit. You know, this is all we're talking about, a lot of the hype around this game. But for our guys, it's about execution and technique and playing hard, which they will. And so will the other team. So it comes down to execution.
Is that the key factors then in your mind going to Bozeman for victory?
Well, anywhere. But, yeah. Yeah, this weekend included.
Coach, overall, how would you assess the way that you're feeling health-wise just as a program, and then any status on Lucas heading into this week?
So first question, you're talking about me personally. I'm good. I had a cold a couple weeks ago and feeling great. You know, we're really hoping that everybody will be ready to play this weekend. That's where we are on Monday at 2, whatever it is. So we're hoping everybody will be ready to go.
Thanks, everybody.
Thanks, guys.
Join Town Pump's Pump It Up Rewards Plus program and never pay full price for fuel again.
Save 5 cents on every gallon every day at any Town Pump across Montana.
Plus, earn and redeem points on your favorite in-store items to get free stuff with our clubs.
Stop in and pick up a rewards card. Download the Pump It Up Rewards Plus app today.
Or visit townpump.com/rewards to register and start saving. Town